Finance Minister Saab, Governor Saab, Chairman SCCP, Chairman PNM, ladies and gentlemen. This is a great deal of discussion around financial inclusion, which makes the financial ecosystem available to everyone by leveling the playing field. Financial inclusion is one of the key means of alleviating poverty, bolstering bottom-up economic growth, empowering women, uplifting the systematically disfranchised in the society, and of course, fostering entrepreneurship for the youth. This is indeed a great equalizer. However, financial inclusion, the great ideal of any financial system, will not be possible until we have developed an inclusive financial and digital system. A system where users, service providers, markets, and intermediaries are free to connect and seamlessly integrate with others in real time with little or no cost. Undeniably, the room for growth in this area is enormous. However, constraints and limitations that hinder the development in this space are still abound. Starting from informality in the economy to erratic economic cycles, weaknesses in legal and judicial framework, exclusion of women from the formal financial system, lack of specific products and efforts to include differently abled transgenders and the likes in the system. And last but not the least is the ability of the financial institutions who knows this business the best, that is microfinance providers, having access to capital that also at the rate at which the lending onwards to most deserving will become affordable. I just witnessed this very interesting discourse before, and I was thinking at that time that, you know, these people are borrowing at enormous rates at this stage, and even then their businesses are flourishing. Just imagine if they were given the loans free of cost or at a minimal rate. That could actually change their lives many fold than what they are right now. The launch of Kamyaab Pakistan program is one such initiative of the government to address this chronic issue and connect the banks, who are predominantly the custodian of public deposits, with the lowest strata of the society through microfinance, through microfinance providers as executing agencies in the program. This is indeed one of the most unique and innovative structure in recent times of effectively addressing this long-standing issue. Credit for this program entirely goes to Finance Minister Mr. Tareen on conceiving this out-of-the-box structure. We all, there are a few of them who are sitting here right now, Aurangzeb, President National Bank, Mr. Usmani, Governor, SCP Chairman, we were all extensively engaged in helping out the execution of this program. The ideal state of an inclusive financial ecosystem will be any transaction to anyone and anywhere. This is only possible through the use of technology, but it's easier said than done. As we embark on this journey, we need to understand the fostering and developing a financial ecosystem is predicted on four main pillars: connectivity, hardware, regulatory momentum, and interoperability. The good news is that we have crossed the first bridge, connectivity. The second, access medium or hardware, is also substantially covered. The groundwork for the third foundation, the regulatory side of things, has been laid. And considering the dynamic nature of the sector, it is likely to be an ongoing process. The last one, interoperability, which is a holy grail and appears to be the toughest nut to crack, to implement it with any degree of effectiveness would require comprehensive multilateral collaboration between technology firms, financial service providers as well as regulatory bodies. The State Bank of Pakistan has taken a number of steps to address the issue of interoperability, including the introduction of micro payment gateway with Karandas. As we move forward with our design of an inclusive platform, we must keep our eye on the ball on key ingredients of a reliable, robust system. Having common standards and best practice codes, consumer protection mechanisms, most important to my mind, with industry baseline security, and of course, the affordability. Another not so subtle factor is silos and turf wars between traditional and non-traditional players. About time that we tear down these walls. Many financial institutions are hesitant to open up and connect the new entities. However, another good news is that the behaviors are changing and collaborative approach is winning. Only 23% of Pakistani adults have accounts with formal financial institutions. The figure stands well below the average of both South Asia and the global level. Pakistan, to reach the global average alone, entails nearly 50 million more people in the financial ecosystem. Notwithstanding, we now have a healthy mix of financial institutions, non-banking financial institutions, digital financial services players, and an emerging fintech industry. I see a lot of them participating here today as well, which is a very good development. In keeping the global trends, the evolution of the sector in Pakistan has been a quick one. Corona restrictions also played a role in this context, like the rest of the world, but we surely had more catching up to do, which we actually did. We have seen how the microfinance industry, mobile wallets, and niche players have emerged to rapidly fill the service vacuum created by technological advancement, and future appears bright, mashallah. Although Naveed has scared us like anything, but I am still very optimistic. I have to be optimistic because I would like to be one of the largest lenders to the microfinance sector. User readiness and adoption rates for emerging digital financial services are also encouraging. Consumers, merchants, businesses, and government bodies have been adopted these changes, albeit at different speeds. The increasing volume of digital transactions is a testament of this growing trend. With an aim to accomplish higher standards of financial inclusion, regulators, State Bank of Pakistan, SECP, have achieved significant milestones over the period of time. Targeted focus on the development of microfinance industry specifically can enable us to achieve increased financial inclusion by bringing more of the underprivileged members of society into the formal economy. These numbers are very well known to you, what the status is. In fact, Ghalib has already covered them. I'll just move on to what Bank of Punjab is doing. We at BOP believe that there is still a long way to go to reap the benefits of financial inclusion from this sector. I am proud of the fact that we are among foremost proponents of microfinance and financial inclusion in Pakistan. We have last week alone celebrated Diversity and Inclusion Week to promote the recently unveiled policy of banking on equality by the State Bank of Pakistan, whereby we have shared what we are doing in the space of public welfare products in alliance with Punjab Social Protection Authority for our employees and offering financing products to encourage financial empowerment. During this week, we had launched first ever Mazdoor card in the country, which will enable us to bring the Mehnat Kash into the fields of formal banking. Another major step in the direction of promoting financial inclusion. We also have this unique honor of perhaps being the first bank in Pakistan to have launched a welfare product for transgenders. As a testament of our further commitment to public service, the Bank of Punjab continues to lend its support to government in its initiatives and at improving the conditions of underprivileged. To this end, a number of subsidized financial products that have been offered recently, most notably Kamyab Jawan, in which we are number one bank in terms of number amount of loans disbursed and numbers of beneficiaries by a wide margin. The Naya Pakistan Housing Society, whereby we have taken the responsibility of addressing the much needed supply side constraints as our duty being the public sector institution to ensure the success of this most critical scheme, and the Punjab Rozgar Program, where we are the only executing agency. The entire work on Kamyab Pakistan Program and its successful launch was also wholeheartedly and most sincerely done by the BOP team supporting the Ministry of Finance in all respects. And we are very proud of that, by the way. BOP has also taken a more focused initiative of investing in the microfinance sector with the aim to support the government's agenda to boost this sector. Our lending portfolio has quadrupled. In the past 3 years alone, we are the lending partner of 14 microfinance providers, including 4 microfinance banks, 10 microfinance institutions. BOP remains keenly aligned with the State Bank of Pakistan's National Financial Inclusion Agenda, sir. As outlined above, and going forward, the objective is to cater to the much wider range of clientele, to do so in a seamless, intuitive, and low-friction manner. Our strategic collaboration and syndicated relationships with the multiple microfinance entities have also geared us towards becoming pioneer of financial inclusion in the areas of agriculture, housing finance, women empowerment, and support for the marginalized and the differently abled. We have recently collaborated with Munsilik Digital, and I was hoping that, you know, looking forward, you would have mentioned that as well. Fahad, somewhere here. Nevertheless, to help them with loan disbursements and collection services and bringing efficiency in cash management system. There are more projects in the pipeline, and BOP is very keen to work with other FIs and fintechs to this end. Stakeholders must work towards bringing more of the unbanked population into the fold of financial inclusivity by easing the transition and simplified onboarding mechanism and user-friendly platform. Numerous microfinance institutions are not self-sufficient and rely heavily on donations and subsidized financing. Therefore, in order to become self-sufficient, it is vital for operations in this sector to build lean, low-cost structures, expand the range of their offerings, and consider repricing existing products and services, which Naveed also mentioned in his talk. The need for this will become more pronounced with the launch of Kamyab Pakistan program. Although ongoing COVID-19 related challenges are unprecedented in terms of magnitude and impact, the microfinance sector has shown enough resilience to cope with them. And I'm still very optimistic that even after those deferments coming to a maturity, we still be able to handle them well. We at the Bank of Punjab remain resolute in addressing the constraints and limitations that impede the development of an inclusive financial ecosystem in Pakistan. We look forward to continue working towards the goal, building upon the success of past, collaborating more readily with other institutions, and productively leveraging the recent advancements in the sector. Thank you very much for your patience.